you should have done, you should have looked over right quick and then look back at me. You should have, you'll get it in a minute. Look and see who your enemy are and then look back to the word of God. Look and see, amen, what's trying to hold you back. And then look back to the word of God. Now what happens to us when the enemy attacks us, we divert our attention, and that's part of his stratagem. We divert our attention to the enemy, but we fail to look back to God. God doesn't want us to focus on the enemy. God wants us to focus on him. I will lift up mine eyes to where? To the hills from whence cometh my help. All of my help, it comes from the Lord that made the heavens and the earth. Everybody, just open your mouth. I don't like to call him out too often, but just put it in the atmosphere and say, devil, you will not distract me this year. Matter of fact, say it another way, and then we'll rush. Say, devil, you will not hold my attention this year. Whatever you distract me with, I'm going to look back to God. Whatever you bring my way. Clap your hands and give God a praise. We got to move. We got to move this year. We got to shift this year. We got to raise our horizons this year. We got to raise our mindset this year. I'm tired of the same old, same old. I'm tired of falling out in prayer lines and getting up the same way when I get back on my feet. I'm tired of having oil smeared all over my head, running in my eyes, dropping on my clothes. If I got to get oiled up, let me get oiled up for something. If I got to get oiled up, let me get some benefit from having the oil on me. You ever notice when the oil is on your right, y'all ain't saying nothing. When the oil is on your right, you become slippery. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Can I get a witness in here? Look at your neighbor and tell them oil is slippery. And the anointing is the smearing of the oil. And that means even if Satan gets a hold of me, ought to slip. Ought to slip right through his hands. We gotta get in that place where I don't stay locked into one position. I got 2 minutes and 42 seconds. I don't want to stay locked into one circumstance. I don't want to stay locked, amen, into misery. That's what happened to Israel, and that's why they failed to move it forward. That's why they failed to progress. They got locked into one situation. They got locked into a mindset. They got locked into a conundrum. They got locked into a circumstance. They got locked into one way of thinking, and it's your thinking that holds you back. Y'all remember I told you last year, stinking thinking. Oh, y'all excuse me. Some of y'all smelled an odor today. It wasn't your neighbor's underarms. It wasn't your neighbor's breath. You were smelling how they think. Amen. They don't think right. Their thinking is stinking because it's stuck in one place. If you stay one way too long, you get stale. If you leave food out the refrigerator, it gets stale. If you put stuff in your car and leave it for the day, y'all ain't saying nothing. You ever left some McDonald's french fries in your car? You ever left a Wendy's burger in your car? And you get back in, it's stinking. It's stinking because it stayed there too long. And some of your thoughts have been locked in one place too long. You got to get progressive with your thinking. I wish I was talking to the right person. Look at your neighbor and say, you got to get progressive. And tell them, if you want to stay stagnated, move on away from me. Get on away. I don't want to be around stuff that thinks, that stinks. I want to get what God has prescribed for me. Israel was stuck. Can I have about 2 more minutes? Israel was stuck. That's why Caleb had to get a hold of them. They went over They spied out. I told you the promised land. They went over. They looked at everything, amen, that God had decreed. And Moses sent them over, remember, to just determine how they were going to do it, how they were going to conquest the land. And the question is never if. The question is how. The question is never if about your deliverance. The question is never if about your victory. The question is never if about your overcoming. The question is how, how, how. Tell your neighbor, pray for me that God will show me how. Tell him, notice. Say, I didn't ask you to pray that God give me the possession. Tell him, I didn't ask you to pray that God gives me the miracle. The possession is already mine. The miracle has already been decreed. I just want to know how to come into my stuff. I want God to show me the pathway. I want God to show me, thank God, the road that I ought to take. I want God to put me in cadence with his time. It's not a question, am I going to get it? It's just a question about God's time. It's not a question, amen, that God, amen, is going to work it out for me. It's just a question about how he's going to work it out for me. I just want to be in the right path. I just want to be in the right frame of mind. I just want to be in that place where my faith is always working. I just want God to keep me at that level, amen, where there's always anticipation percolating in my belly. Can I get a witness in here? Tell your neighbor, that's why I'm up when I'm down. Amen. Because in the worst of times, I'm anticipating the next move of God. In the darkest of days, up your hand and shout glory. In the darkest of days, amen, I'm looking for some light to flicker through. And just for a moment, let me deviate. That old hymn of the church just popped up in my mind. It's an encouraging song, and they used to sing it back in the day when life got rough, when life got difficult. I hear some of those old preachers singing it. I hear my pastor singing it. I hear the late Bishop Stanley Halton singing it. I hear them. And they would say, in the darkest of times, when the saints were going through back then, when most saints didn't have money, when they were living from day to day, when they were battling sickness and illness and dealing with racial prejudice in the culture and in the society, when life was hard and they lived in the ghetto and things were difficult, but I hear them saying that old hymn, courage, oh my soul, and let us journey on. Though the night be dark, it won't be very long. Thanks be to God. Oh, the morning light appears. The storm is passing over. That just dropped in my spirit. Tap your neighbor on the shoulder and tell him the storm is passing over. The storm. That's what keeps you going. That's what keeps you going. I can't guarantee you a trouble-free life. That's why I don't feel bad about what I'm preaching. I'm not preaching fallacy. I'm not preaching a carefree life. I'm not trying to, amen, be false with my membership and false with those that come to hear me preach. I'm not trying to tell you that life doesn't get difficult. It will get difficult. I might be talking to somebody that's in a difficult place this morning. I might be talking to somebody, and I know somebody may be sitting here. I'm not in a difficult place, but let me tell you, you will be. If this ain't for you today, put it in the can for another day, because everybody is going to be in a difficult place. But what I want to tell you is that the morning light will appear. You might be in the storm, but the joy in the midst of the storm is knowing that the storm is passing over. It won't be long and the clouds will dissipate. It won't be long. Clap your hand. Clap your hand and shout glory. Shout glory another time. It's 12:16, and we got to get ready to leave out of this place. But reach over and shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, say, would you receive it if I told you that it ain't going to be too much longer? I'll find you somebody that look like they want to believe. Pivot to your other side and say, hey neighbor, would you receive it if I told you it ain't gonna be too long, the check will be in the mail. It ain't gonna be too long, your sickness is gonna be healed. It ain't gonna be too long, there's gonna be another miracle in your house. It ain't gonna be too long, God's gonna bless your children. Hold on, child of God. Weeping only endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning. I got to close here now. Can I have 90 seconds to close? Somebody lift your hand and shout glory today. Would you shout glory? Shout glory one more time. Do me a favor as I get ready to close this afternoon and shake one more hand and say, hey neighbor, the preacher told me to say this to you. It may sound like it's out of order, but he told me to tell you what the Bible says. For yet a little while, and he that shall come, he will come. I just rose. I wish I could preach. Can I preach anyhow? I just rose to tell Mount Zion. I feel a turnaround. I feel a change in the atmosphere. I feel a shift in my situation. Change your mind. Change your attitude. Come on out the wilderness. I wish I had me a praying church. If you can find a neighbor that don't mind, reach over, grab them by the hand, give them a gentle pull, and say, come on out the wilderness. Say, come on, let's get over this Jordan. Come on, let's climb this mountain. Let us go up and possess the land. Let us go up and get what God got for you. Let us go up. I wish I could preach. I wish I could preach. I got to close, but shake another hand and say, now, y'all ain't helping me. Would you open up your mouth and say, now, y'all ain't helping me. Shout it out and say, now is the time to shift your thinking. Look at them. Grab their hand. Say, look at me. Say, did you hear what I said? Now is the time to change your thinking. Now is the time to change your attitude. Now is the time to shift your faith to the next level and let the devil hear you say, what God has for me, it is for me. This is my year. This is my time. This is my hour. And while I'm waiting on it, I'm going to praise him. While I'm waiting on it, I'm going to give God glory. While I'm waiting on it, I will rejoice. Rejoice in the morning. Rejoice at noonday. Rejoice in the midnight hour. Rejoice when I'm out. Rejoice when I'm in. Rejoice when I'm jumping. Rejoice when I'm crying. I will. I need about 20 folk for 10 seconds that will give God a faith praise. 20 folk. Everybody standing who's able to stand.